Brian Long, Chairman of King's Lynn Thames Drains Board. Thank you for coming. Really pleased that you've been able to attend.
You're a new bit.
Can I introduce you to Philip Calamine? He's the Chief Executive of the Drainage Board, and he will in turn introduce you to people who've been involved in making this project happen.
Welcome to the Drainage Station, Your Majesty. Ma'am, if I could introduce two guys who've really put a lot of work into building this station, which is fantastic. I'll give you a quick overview of what we've done. We've built a brand new flood defence pumping station, which replaced the old station, which was just outside there. It's on the flat ground, just outside the gate. After 70 years of service, it had come to the end of its life.
And, 70?
70, yes. Just over 70 years, yes. I think it was 72, in fact. 72 years. It was really sort of falling down, so we had to do some two river systems, Dursingham Main Drain and River Ingle, together to create one integrated drainage system, a new pumping station. So that's what we did. So when the pumps work, they draw the water through the pumps underneath where we're stood and out through the sea bank and into the wash. And the pumps are controlled by some fantastic electronic wizardry in the control building over there. And if the power fails, then the backup generator in the of the station. This station protects about 13,500 acres of arable land, plus Snettisham, Wolferton, Dursingham, Inglesthorpe. That's right, a great big area. And this station, the pumping, keeps safe. So what I'd like to do now, which is the first group of the guys really that designed and built the station. So, ma'am, may I present Simon Darch, his team from Stantec, who designed the station.
Oh, right. Mm-hmm. Where the water.
Yeah,
the
pipes, the valves, etc., and the structure.
So this is a very, it's a really up-to-date creature, is it?
Oh, definitely. Yeah, it's one of the most up-to-date there is. Yeah, we've got some innovative pumps in there which protect the fish as well, which of course some better pumps will no doubt.
Oh, really? Yeah. Does this protect the fish? No, I didn't even find any fish around here. Seems extraordinary.
This was the environmental officer on the project, keeping us all on the straight and narrow, along with Caroline Laban, who's also an environmental officer on the project. Been involved from the start through to the finish, making sure that we're always doing what we should be doing. Okay. May I also present Dave Gorham from Brahini. Brahini basically built the station.
So you built it?
Yes, you built it.
Is this your people working on here?
At times, yes. Mm-hmm. We have 20 to 30. Yeah. In a small area.
Yes, because it's quite compact, isn't it? And you found the right place to put it.
Just
compared where the old one was.
Yeah, to work around the old structure.
We kept the old one running until the last minute, just so that pump protection was maintained.
Yes. Which was quite interesting at the time.
From Bedford Pumps?
So these pumps are...
We made these, made them in the UK in Bedfordshire. So it's, I think as I heard some of our colleagues saying before, it's real market leading technology. So the eel friendly pumps, we can pass migratory eels through the pumps without any harm. And. We're now exporting these pumps all over the globe, as far as New Zealand, Canada, where there are also similar concerns.
Oh, that's very good, isn't it? So we have a very modern pumping station.
Yes.
Now, if I could present John Wright from Pactronics, they supplied all of the electronic wizardry.
We're in a modern world.
Yeah. Well, technology is always changing, isn't it? Yeah. Somebody invents something different.
Quite.
No, it's rather nice to think that this is a sort of going to be a dry area.
Oh, yes.
Because we've had some terrible problems here.
Really?
All the banks disappeared and flooded. Yeah. And, Then we had to start with new seawall and extraordinary. How it's been worth its weight in gold, right?
Oh,
the
yes,
whole pumping
station. Yes. That's right.
Extraordinary.
Yes, it lasted a long time. And this one from stainless metal craft. His company supplied and installed the overhead automatic weed screen cleaner you see just above the pumps there.
The purpose of which is to make sure that we keep our...
Well, it's automated, so it can operate without any intervention. Made here in Great British Engineering, made in the Fens locally.
Oh, is it?
Yes,
oh, right.
Yeah, in Chatteris, sort of market town, not far.
Mm-hmm. Not far.
Yes.
Drive through it quite often. But it's...
So it's important to have the automatic cleaner that removes all of the debris, so that it keeps pumping. Who's the chief executive of the Borough Council for Kingsland and West Norfolk?
All right. Good morning.
And Paul Burrows from the Environment Agency, who's the Flood Risk and Coastal Manager. The Majestic Agency's Regional Flood and Coastal Committee for Anglian Central.
Yeah, the Great Ouse catchment.
Yes.
This is quite a big area to cover, isn't it?
So it's a very big area, yeah. The Great Ouse Catchment is about 8,000 square kilometres,
is
so
it?
Big area right up to sort of Northants, Brackley, Buckingham, Milton Keynes,
is it?
Right through down to the Wash, so very big area to cover, lots of different types of flood risk, and obviously in this part of the world, lots of low-lying land and lots of pumping stations.
Yes.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, so there are lots of pumping stations coming to the sort of end of their original lives that are now needing refurbishments, and this is one of the first that I've seen in my time in this role.
Who is it?
Helping secure the funding for them.
Mm. That's very good, isn't it?
Yes, exactly. That really cool. We decided the water level by surveying the upstream areas, and the pumps are then set to pump at levels that will not allow the water to come out of the levels upstream, so we don't flood it. They pump 1,600 litres per second, like 96,000 litres.
If I could present Sam Markilly, who's been a board member of Kings and Lords.
Quite a long time.
Yes, well, also with all the management of the office as well.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, well, again, yes, all the same. Also, so it's a good thing.
Yeah, I see.
If I can present John Askew, who's been a board member for Kings Lynn for 20 years.
Oh, yes. And that works
Quite important for this part of the work. Quite important. I'm happy to present Francis Bly, who's worked for the board for 22 years.
I started just after university, and my job roles changed and expanded as the years have gone on.
Yes.
My father and his father worked for the game as well. I think that's quite unusual, isn't it?
Yes.
3 generations like that.
Yes, if I could
take you to the plaque that's hung in the old station, the lovely photo. When he was owned by his father, the 2nd of February 1948. We found those in the archives.
Did you?
Yes. And when you go through the old money books, you can see that the old station cost £14,293.
Now?
Yeah, and now it's 5 million. The newest station cost 5 million, so that station cost £14,000. It's amazing, isn't it? Yeah.
Church to be.
No, that's right. Yeah.
So this is the construction, is it?
Yes, this is. I'll just show you the map first of where we are. That's obviously the map. Generator in the other buildings, and that's all done automatically. So basically the panels in five sections, so we've got the generator panel over there, we've got some harmonic distortion stuff in here, which basically fills out all of the bad stuff to back to the mains. So we don't want to fill with any mains back up in the village or anything like that. And then we've got the three pump control panels, and then the important part here, which is the level control. Which is the human machine interface, which switches the pumps on and off. As I said, all of the controls are in there for levels, and then if that gets defeated by the levels, if we've had heavy weather, the next one will start, and so on. And then automatically come back the other way once the water levels start retreating again. So totally automatic, so we don't have to interfere with anything. Have an integrated telemetry system that allows us to see everything that's happening down here remotely from the office or home or on the mobile phone. So the whole thing is totally automatic. That's about all for that, I think, but what we would like to invite you is to actually start a pump by pressing the famous red button here that we've had installed specially. We're doing this last thing because it gets quite noisy once things start. So if you'd like to press the red button, we can start.
See what happens.
So what's happening now is the filter system starts first. That stuff goes back to the mains. Then the pump slowly starts in reverse to fill up the fish away. And then it will slowly speed up and start going. Distributors as we can be. Hence the reason everything starts first. So I'd just like to ask Colin if he could perhaps say a few words about the actual construction of this particular aspect of the
river. Yeah, of course. So what we're standing on now is the new River Ingle intake.
Yeah.
So now the river flows out through two big culverts by gravity, straight through the sea bank and out to the sea. And then when that's tide locked, the big tide or whatever, it can now overflow through some... goes through another culvert back into the pumping station where it can be pumped away.
The old embankment flood the old pumping station that was here. So we used to have a sort of precarious balance between us and the IDB about how we managed the river. But now it's this is done away with all that. So it's far better managed.
Your Majesty, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, it makes me very proud today to be here in front of a new pumping station. The general public don't necessarily understand the work that drainage boards do. But for people in this part of the world, having drainage boards and the facility that they bring actually allows us to live and work and not least grow crops in this part of Norfolk. Without the pumps, without the drainage, it simply wouldn't happen. This pumping station is a testament to the collaborative work between ourselves as a small drainage board with bigger partners and not least the contractors who've helped deliver it for us. Your Majesty, it is absolute honour that you're here today, and I do hope that the people of West Norfolk appreciate the value that you bring to this area and also the facility that we provide in keeping people's feet dry. It is, yes, it is. Your Majesty, I have, I'd say a small bit. This is photographs of your father when he opened our pumping station in 1948, and I'm hoping that our new station lasts as long that you've opened for us today.
Oh, that's very kind. Thank you very much indeed. That's interesting that there was a dog in the picture.
Yes, you didn't bring yours down.
No. I thought they might crawl into the river.
Yes.
They had a dog there, didn't
they? I believe so. Yes.
Well, I have somebody here who very used to carry loot. Thank you very much. It's very kind.
Thank you.